us fierce storms heading our way and getting closer.
We're live as the storms roll in. Our first floor weather team has what you need to know. It's all right now on your WOX News at 10.
This is WOX News Now at 10. Your news for South Mississippi starts now.
Tonight, we're starting with a live look at our WOX storm tracker in Harrison County. Wind picking up ahead of some strong storms tonight.
Now, this is the same storm system that left this damage you see here in Texas on that side of your screen and here in West Louisiana. The same storm system producing all of this damage. And it actually produced multiple tornadoes, including one outside of Houston. Authorities are calling the damage catastrophic.
First Alert Weather Team is watching this storm system right now. Let's go straight over to Taylor Graham for the latest. There we go. Hopefully everyone can hear me now. Sorry about the technical difficulties. We'll go ahead and take a look back at that tornado watch if we can. Tornado watch in effect for all of South Mississippi until 5 o'clock Wednesday morning. Chances are that is going to be probably lifted before then. We expect the main line of showers and storms to roll on through pretty much between now through 2 o'clock on Wednesday morning. And some of these thunderstorms may have some strong wind gusts near 60 miles per hour, and a few tornadoes also can't be ruled out. So this is why we issue today as an alert day. We want everyone to stay weather aware late tonight into early Wednesday morning. Also, ahead of this system, we've been dealing with some very strong wind gusts. You could potentially see some gusts ahead of the storms in the 40s and the 50s, mainly out of the southeast and the south. That could cause some coastal flooding as well. Now, good news is by tomorrow afternoon, things are going to be calmer, cooler, and once we get past those showers and thunderstorms tonight, I do expect most of the week to be much better. But for tonight, keep an eye out to the sky for some of those showers and storms. We will continue to keep a close eye on that as we head into the rest of tonight, and we'll have a closer look at your forecast coming up in a few moments.
All right, Taylor, thank you. Now, we do have teams out across South Mississippi tonight as the storm system moves in. Let's check in with Jacoby now, who is live in Hancock County, where the storm system is getting closer to tonight.
That's right, dude. We've been in Hancock County pretty much all day today since 4 o'clock. It has been the same thing over and over again, the winds and the water. Now, I'm sort of going to take a step away, as you can see behind me. Right now, the wind is picking up here along the beach here in Waveland, and you may not see it, but the white caps are coming in, and the winds are definitely picking up, and that has been the very story of all day. Earlier today, we were at the Silver Slipper, and while the wind was picking up around earlier today, many people had the opportunity to come out and enjoy themselves by kite surfing. I believe around two or three of them were out here kite surfing along the Silver Slipper along Highway 90 and Highway Boulevard, where the winds were picking up and the white caps were washing and hitting against the seawall along Highway 90. And that's pretty much the story of today. Many people in the yacht club earlier today in Bay St. Louis, they're preparing to make sure their boats are not going anywhere. They're tying up the boats with ropes close to the docks to make sure it's extra secure. Many boats had two to three ropes tied to it, making sure it is rocky to make sure it's not going anywhere. Along with the ropes, many of those boats had tarps covering for the rain to make sure there's no rain damage or anything wet in their boats when they're coming back in the morning to make sure everything's okay. But Hugh, the wind, like I said, it's been a major factor for the entire day, and it's a factor here right now. We're getting a little sprinkle of rain at the moment, not too heavy, but just a little sprinkle now and then here in Waveland, Hancock County, where the storm is pretty much making its way here. Reporting Waveland, Jacoby Rivers, WLOX News Now.
Thanks, Jacoby. Harrison County also on alert for storms tonight. Stephanie Poole out live in the storm tracker. Stephanie, what are you seeing out there?
Yeah, that's right, Jennifer. Hunter and I are heading east on Highway 90. Now, as far as right now, everything seems smooth. Now, outside of the storm tracker, you can see that it's still dry on the road. You don't see too much rain. and make their way to their safe place. But it was close to hear that wind beating outside of the window just a few minutes before we came on air. I actually saw a few palm trees blowing quite a bit, so that's something that I will be keeping my eye on. And again, make sure you're staying in a safe place and outside of the road if you have to, because again, if those weather conditions get worse, we do want you to stay in a safe location. So make sure you are not outside if you don't have to be. Now, coming up later in the show, I will have another look here on Highway 90 and into those later evening hours. But for now, reporting live here in Biloxi, Stephanie Poole, WLOX.
And we will have a closer look at the forecast coming up in just a bit. First, dozens fill the Ground Zero Blues Club in Biloxi for the...
best in the country.
Courtney Ann Jackson, WLOX News Now. And we are closely watching a line of severe thunderstorms getting closer and closer to South Mississippi. I'll have the latest on that severe weather threat coming up in a few minutes, but first, here's a quick look at your marine forecast for tomorrow.
Peanut butter. It's that jiffing good. Ludacris changed his flow for it.
The WLOX First Alert Radar is sponsored by Mississippi Power. Find ways to save energy and money for your home or business at MississippiPower.com.
Now, WLOX First Alert Weather with meteorologist Taylor Grant.
The wind continues. This strong line of showers and thunderstorms, and we have been watching some severe thunderstorms with the system this evening, not too far off, and it looks like this line now beginning to move over Lake Pontchartrain, and we can see, in addition to some of that severe weather, also some heavy rainfall, a good bit of lightning, and this will continue to push eastward over the next few hours. And if you didn't know, a tornado watch has been issued for all of South Mississippi until 5 o'clock in the morning, but to be honest, because these showers and storms are going to be moving in and out fairly quickly, wouldn't be surprised if that watch is turned back a little bit earlier. But taking a wider view, we can see that some of those stronger to severe storms extend all the way down into southeast Louisiana. These will continue to sweep through overnight tonight, mainly through about 2 o'clock in the morning. And it does look like some of that warm, unstable air has been able to move over South Mississippi. So there's a chance that these strong thunderstorms are going to be able to hold together as they move eastward in that warm and stable air, providing some fuel for some of those showers and storms. This is a pretty strong low-pressure system that continues to move up to the north and east, and behind it we can see a little bit of snow, but of course for us, far too warm for that. And as these storms get closer to us, our main concern, still some strong wind gusts over 60 miles per hour, and a few spread of tornadoes can be rolled out, which is why that tornado watch has been issued. Flooding and hail on the low wind risk, but again, some heavy downpours are certainly possible, but it is good that these showers and storms are going to be moving in and out fairly quickly. This run of future cast shows the main line passing through very quickly, actually, between about 11 and 1 o'clock. Once we get to about 2 or 3 o'clock, it looks like most of the rain moves out of the way, and winds will be shifting from the west and northwest, helping to bring in some cooler air waking up on Wednesday morning. Now, ahead of this line, it's still going to be very windy, even under that high wind warning today, and I still wouldn't rule out a few gusts ahead of the storms in the 40s and 50s, and that wind mainly will be out of the south and southeast. So we still have that high wind warning in effect for all of South Mississippi through early Wednesday morning, and with that wind from the south and southeast, that could also cause some coastal flooding. Coastal flood advisory remains in effect for Harrison and Jackson County. Coastal flood warning, though, in effect for Hancock County. Those low-lying areas over in Hancock County little bit more vulnerable to some of that flooding. And we're also coming up on high tide, it looks like, over the next couple of hours. So this is going to be the prime time of getting some of that coastal flooding. We will be seeing low tide throughout the morning, and at that point, the wind will be shifting from the west and northwest. But as we take a look at the current wind gusts right now, they're holding pretty strong in the 20s and 30s. And again, I still wouldn't rule out some gusts in the 40s and 50s ahead of this line of showers and storms. And it also looks like we've warmed up a little bit more across the coast. 66 right now at Keesler Air Force Base in Biloxi. Dew points have also climbed up into the 60s, meaning that we've got some of that humidity in place. It's going to be easier for the showers and storms to sustain themselves. So we can see that over the next couple of hours, we may even warm up just a little bit more ahead of that main line. By midnight, the line will be pushing through South Mississippi, roughly right around Highway 49. And then, as we get into Wednesday morning, cooler and drier air will be moving in, and temperatures will be dropping into the upper 40s and the low 50s. We just want everyone to stay weather aware tonight in case we get any of those severe thunderstorm warnings or tornado warnings. Hopefully that's not the case, but again, there is that potential. But once we get through the storms tonight, things are looking much calmer by the end of the week, and high temperatures will only be in the upper 50s by Thursday and Friday. Thanks, Taylor.